Welcome to our video on KingswaySoft Dynamics 365 Toolkit. Today we will be going over our Dynamics AX F&O components, which can connect to your AX 4.0 to 2012 R3, as well as to your D365 finance and operations instances. As a first step, after you have installed our components, open an integration services project, and within a package inside it, right-click on the Connection Manager section. From the list that comes up, choose Dynamics AX Connection Manager, double-click on it, or select Add to open up the Connection Manager user interface. The Connection Manager contains the following three pages for configuring how to connect to the Microsoft Dynamics AX server: General, Advanced Settings, and More Info. Note that the Advanced Settings page would change based on the Connection API that you choose. The Connection API dropdown allows you to specify which type you want to use to build the connection. It has two options, Business Connector and OData. Choose Business Connector if you want to connect to any of the AX 4.0 to AX 2012 R3 instances. This gives you an option to enter your username and your user domain. Please note that this type of connections work with the Microsoft Dynamics AX .NET Business Connector, and this needs to be installed on the developer machine and or on your integration servers for the connections to work seamlessly. And it is usually shipped with the AX installation package. In the Advanced Settings page, which is specific to Business Connector, you could provide the proxy account information, namely username, password, and domain. And there are optional settings that includes object server name, configuration name, company, language, and tenant. Coming back to the general page, let's choose the connection API as OData if you have a D365 finance and operation instance to connect to. This works over the OData API over service calls. There are three OAuth methods that we support from which you could select one. The password OAuth type, when chosen, allows you to specify the username and the password for the user account along with the other server and tenant information in order to connect to your Dynamics 365 for finance and operations instance. While working with this approach, you would notice an authorize button that shows up. By clicking the authorize button, it will pop up an application access authorization window to help you authorize the application to access your Dynamics 365 F&O data. All you need to do is to provide the redirect URL, depending on your Azure application's application type. For native application, put the redirect URI of the application into the redirect URL field. For web app or API application, put the sign-on URL of the application into the redirect URL field. The prompt will take you through the authorization process through either the app or through the browser, depending on what you choose. The second option is certificate, which when selected, gives a new field which allows you to specify the thumbprint once you have selected or created an application in Microsoft Azure Entra ID. Note that for this, the prerequisite would be generating a thumbprint in Azure Entra ID, and for that you would need to create a public slash private key pair using OpenSSL or any such standard methods. Upload the public key to your Azure app to generate the thumbprint, and the private key needs to be installed on the machine or server from where you wish to establish the connection. The third OAuth option is client credentials, which works on server-to-server authentication and does not require a thumbprint or username or password. In this example, we will be working with the client credentials OAuth approach. Next, you would need to fill up the rest of the fields in the Connection Manager. The authorization server URL option allows you to specify your authorization server endpoint, which you can use to authorize the application to access your D365 F&O data. This option is by default set to https://login.windows.net when connecting to D365 F&O data. Depending on your environment, you can provide your custom URL by checking the Use a Custom URL option. The Service URL option allows you to specify your organization's root service endpoint, which you can use to connect to your D365 F&O instance. The Service Resource option works with the authorization server URL to work for OAuth scenarios. The Active Directory Tenant field allows you to specify the tenant name or the tenant ID, where the client app ID is verified to complete the authorization process. The client app ID will be the GUID value that identifies a client application in Microsoft Azure Entra ID. And Client Secret option allows you to specify the client secret that you have generated, which will be used to authenticate using the Azure web application. Note that you may need to register your application with Azure Entra ID via the Azure portal in order to generate your client app ID and client secret. The data scope dropdown provides two options to select from. You can specify the scope of this connection as default company or all companies. And the service timeout field is used to set a timeout value in seconds for the connection. The default value is 120 seconds. In the advanced settings page specifically for OData type, you can use the proxy mode to specify how you want to configure the proxy server settings. There are three options available: no proxy, auto detect for using system configured proxies, manual for entering manual proxy information as required. You could also enable the checkbox proxy authentication required to provide any additional network credentials. The retry on intermittent errors option is designed to help recover from possible intermittent outages or disruption of service. It prevents the integration process from stopping due to temporary issues. Enabling this option will allow service call to be retried upon certain types of failures. A service call may be retried up to 4 times before an exception is fired. And ignore certificate errors checkbox can be used to ignore those SSL certificate errors when connecting to Dynamics 365 finance and operations instances. Please note that enabling the ignore certificate errors option is generally not recommended, particularly for production instances, unless there is a strong reason to believe the connection is secure, such as the network communication is only happening in an internal infrastructure. This option should be unchecked for best security. When this option is enabled, it applies to all HTTP-based SSL connections in the same job process. It is not just limited to the D365 FNO connections. Once you have all the required information entered, click on Test Connection to validate the authentication. You would get a Test Connection Succeeded message box, and now click on OK to save and close the Connection Manager. Next, we drag and drop our KingswaySoft Dynamics AX source component from the SSIS toolbox. Note that this component works for both AX and FNO instances, and Dynamics AX is a common terminology which we choose to use. Double-click to open the user interface. In here, choose the connection manager from the list of connections. If you have more than one connection, then that would show up in the list dropdown. There are two source types that are supported: entity and recurring export, from which you can choose the one that you wish to work with. When entity option is selected, the component will retrieve a list of all available entities for the selected connection. And when recurring export option is selected, it allows you to export data from a data project that is pre-configured in Dynamics 365 FNO. Let's first look at how the entity option works. The source entity option is only available after you have selected OData as your connection API in AX Connection Manager. When the option is selected, the component will retrieve a list of all available AX FNO entities for the selected AX connection. Let's choose our entity. The batch size option allows you to specify how many records you want to retrieve each time. The default value is 1000, and this option is only available when working with the entity's source type. The max rows returned option allows you to limit the number of rows returned. When specified, the AX source component will stop paging as soon as exact number of records have been retrieved. When the option is set to 0, it will retrieve all satisfying records by automatically paging through the entire dataset. The filtering condition grid allows you to specify the filtering conditions so that the source component only returns those records that satisfy such conditions. You could choose one or many filters and provide the conditions as required from the available list of fields and operators. This works on an AND condition by default. The order by field can be used to specify the order by clause. Clicking on the ellipsis button would open up the order by builder window. The columns page of the Dynamics AX source component shows you all columns available from the entity or query that you have defined on your general page. You can choose to select all or select just the ones that you require. On the top left of the grid, you can see a checkbox which can be used to toggle the selection of all available fields. This is a productive way to have a view of the selected ones. And the data type can be clicked to toggle through the available ones that suits the field as well. Now, let's switch to recurring export source type. Here, you can choose some additional options such as legal entity, export project, and job entity name. The legal entity option allows you to specify the legal entity for the data export. The export project option allows you to specify the name of the data project, and the job entity name option allows you to specify the name of the entity within the specified data project. The general page would look different when you choose Business Connector as your connection API in your connection manager. As you can see here, you can use the text editor to enter a Dynamics AX query statement, which is typically a select statement with source tables represented by %n format, where n is an integer. For instance, %1 can be used to represent the first table, %2 for the second, and so on. We support the use of user and system variables as well. Simply select a variable under the Insert Variables drop-down menu, and a placeholder value will be inserted into the filter text. Click on OK to save and close the component. By clicking on the Refresh Component button, the component will try to retrieve the latest metadata and update each field to its most recent metadata. The blue FX button that you see, it launches the SSIS Expression Editor to enable dynamic updates of the properties at runtime. Next, we look at our KingswaySoft Dynamics AX destination component. Note that we have a premium SQL Server source component here as our source, and we are connecting it to our Dynamics AX destination in order to enable its configuration. Double-click on the destination component to open the user interface. Choose the connection manager from the list. The destination entity or table option allows you to specify which entity or table to write the data. When the option is clicked, the component will retrieve a list of all available entities for the selected connection. The action option can be used to specify how the data should be written to the instance. We support four major actions, namely create to create new records, update to perform updates, delete to delete specific records, and upsert to update any existing records in AX if match can be found, otherwise create a new record with the information from the upstream pipeline components. Note that upsert action works on manually specified key matches, and hence the warning messages that we see below asking for the matching fields to be selected from the columns page. There are some optional settings that are available only while working with Business Connector in the Connection Manager. The Ignore Unchanged Fields option allows you to ignore any fields that have not been changed in the target AX system. With this option selected, the destination component will check the target AX system and compare each field to see if there are any changes for them. The component will only post the fields that have actual changes. The Ignore Null Valued Fields option allows you to ignore any fields that have a null value. By ignoring a field, the null value will not be posted to the target AX system. This can help avoid the situation that you overwrite non-empty values with an empty value if your requirement dictates so. The Include Non-Editable Fields option allows you to view all fields in the specified AX table. The Bypass Table Method option allows you to import data into the target AX system without firing or triggering any table method, which essentially skips all server-side business logic and data validations. We support multi-threaded feature, which allows you to perform multi-threading when writing to the instance. To configure this, you can check the Enable Multi-Threaded Writing option in the AX destination component when working with D365 FNO. The default number is 16. This option supports a maximum number of 100 threads when writing to FNO. We generally recommend 20 or lower to avoid potential server errors. However, you can adjust these settings based on your environment in order to get the best performance. The Send Datetime Values in UTC format option allows you to send datetime values in UTC format. And the batch size option is to specify how many records you want to submit to your instance at one time in each service call. On the columns page, you would see a grid which has already mapped fields if the label values match as that from the upstream pipeline to the ones in the AX destination entity or table. You could click on Hide Unmapped Fields to view the mapped fields. This is a good way to separate mapped fields from unmapped ones for easy viewing. Perform the mappings as required. Once mapped, you can choose the manually specified keys as seen here. You could check one or more than one field to specify that those are the ones you need to use as the key. There is a key field in the grid that shows you whether a field is a business key or not. You could choose to use one of those as the matching fields or not. Now, we move on to the error handling page. The error handling page allows you to specify how errors should be handled when they occur. There are three options available: fail on error, redirect rows to error output, ignore error. Along with that, we also support enabling few columns like the business key fields for the default output, which would help in integration scenarios. Choose the error handling as redirect rows to error output and click on OK to save and close the component. And then, drag and drop dummy destinations so that we can connect and inspect both the error output as well as the default output metadata. In the default output metadata, you can see that the columns that we had chosen in the component is present along with the input data from the upstream pipeline. And in the error output metadata, there are three additional fields along with the input columns, namely error code, error column, and AX error message. These would be advantageous if you wish to identify what type of errors have occurred for the records. One important thing to note in the component is the refresh component option. By clicking this button, the component will retrieve the latest metadata from the AX server and update each field. After clicking this button, you will receive the following screen once the refresh is done. We would also like to show you an additional component we have in the Dynamics AX toolkit, which is the AX next sequence number. Drag and drop the component and connect the source to it. This would be used in before the AX destination component as shown here. This is a transformation component that allows you to get the next sequence number from the AX server that you can use as the input for one of the input columns of your AX destination component. The sequencing number capability would first have to be set up properly in AX. Please note that this component only works with Business Connector, and choosing the FNO connection manager throws the error. The reason is that next sequence number function is not needed when working with Dynamics 365 FNO. Leave the sequence number field unmapped in the destination component, and it will automatically assign a new sequence number to the field as the write takes place. Therefore, we choose the write connection and then enter the sequence number and the output column name. The scope option is used to specify the scope of the sequence number defined in AX. There are two options available. Global, choose this option if the sequence number is defined in the global scope, which means it is available to all companies in the same installation. And the second one is company, which you can choose if the sequence number is defined in the company level. Now it's ready to be mapped to the destination component as required. We hope this video has helped in understanding the working and features of our Dynamics 365 toolkit for AX and finance and operations components. KingswaySoft, data integration made easy.